All right, guys, welcome back to part three of the January 2015 ban list, final ban list discussion video, part three. Oh my god. So we're going to keep on moving on. Like I said, I kind of want to wrap this up before the first, so let's go ahead and jump right into it. So starting off, we have Spoonflaps12. So he pretty much gave a list, so that's much easier. So not only do I know your opinion, but I can go ahead and give my opinion on your opinion. So starting it off, for Forbidden, he has BLS. I doubt it. BLS hasn't been doing much. I mean, he's a very powerful card, but he's not powerful enough to be banned. You know, so that's not even a thing. Life Equalizer. What is Life Equalizer? I think it's card when the difference between both players is 8,000 or more. Both players' life points become 3,000. Is that supposed to be some kind of burn shit? Like, I don't understand. That's not even relevant to the format or anything right now, so that's not gonna get addressed. Vanity's Emptiness, I think that's probably gonna get limited over banned. I just don't see that card being that ban worthy. But yeah, I guess I see where you're coming from with that. So yeah, if it gets banned, I don't care, but I think it's probably gonna get limited. Alright, next, for limited. Majesty's Fiend. Majesty's Fiend, isn't that like the Vanity's, isn't that like Majesty's Vanity's Emptiness? Majesty's Fiend? Majesty's Fiend. Where is Majesty's Fiend? There he is. Monster effects can't be activated. Really? Majesty's Fiend? I kinda feel like Vanity's Fiend would be the worst one, so no, I don't see Majesty's Fiend getting hit. Like I say right now, if anything should be hit, I'd say it should be Monarch Stormforth, but no, not Majesty's Fiend. Tour Guide from the Other World to 1. That's a little too extreme. I think maybe 2 would be fine. And you have Vanity's Fiend. Like I said, I kind of feel like Monarch Stormforth and, if need be, Soul Exchange would be a little bit more necessary. Because just being able to tribute your opponent's monsters, that's the problem. You know, the whole tributing mechanic with those monsters is fair. But, you know, being able to tribute your opponent's monsters, that's when, you know, it gets kind of frowned upon. So I'd say that those two cards first. Shadal Fusion to 1, I think it's a little bit too extreme, maybe 2. Scale Drain to 1, yeah, I can see that. Wind Up Carrier, some Mighty. Nah. I don't know. I'm not sure how Konami feels, TCG Konami feels about Wind Ups. I kind of feel like when it comes to Wind Ups, they know that the deck's dead. There's no reason to move the Mighty. Then we're not as, you know, liberal as OCG Konami, so I can kind of see that card just sitting there, so meh. Deep Sea Diva, no, I don't see that. Zector Hornet, no, I don't see that either. There's a lot of these cards I see, there's just no reason to move them. Like I said, I'm a very conservative Yu-Gi-Oh player, so, you know, unless I see Konami move it, then I generally won't move it as well. You know, I gotta see Konami move it, and then me be like, all right, that's what you want to do, Konami, before I'm just like, oh yeah, you know, we should move that. All right, Abyss God, no, definitely not. Mermels are still good. Like, Mermels still top, so, you know, everyone's in a blue moon. Mermels are not dead, so no. Not good, definitely not. Goyo Guardian, no. Goyo Guardian is fine at 1, no. For a 28 beater like that, no. Darkhold, really? Nah. Darkhold and Mergeki are fine, both at 1, no. I was gonna give you 2 Darkholds if you didn't give the Mergeki, but no. I can tell you are very liberal. I mean, when it comes to the meta, you wanna kick the meta in the nuts hard, but then when it comes to other things, you're very liberal. So, what next? Sacred Sword of seven stars. Sacred Sword of the Seven Stars. I doubt it. There's, you know, it's one of those Dragon Ruler format cards. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. So, you know, that's how Konami feels. So I doubt it. They're not gonna move that. Toronto Tribute. No. Toronto Tribute, Darkhold, Regeki. Those are all just master monster destruction cards. They're all fine at 1. Yeah. Despite destruction not being the best in right now, they're just all fine at 1. I don't see them moving anywhere else past that. Alright, Unlimited, Gale, yeah, I can see that. Globe Bulb, yeah, sure, I can see that. Gores, sure, I can see that. Trag, nah. Trag is stronger than Gores, so I kind of feel like Trag should just stay at 2. That's another one that's aim broke, don't fix it, keep Trag at 2. But Gores, you know, you want to play triple Gores, hang more power to you. Dark Jet Fighter, yeah, I can see that. Reasoning, no, I said Reasoning previously in previous list, and it didn't get moved. It's just been sitting there, too, so I don't see it. Trans Migration Prophecy, yeah, I see that. And World of Ring Light, no, I don't see that. There's apparently My god, I can't think of what it is called. Was it like reversal quiz or whatever? Yeah. So no, just being able to, you know, Wolverine, like, drop your life points and then, you know, do that. No. So no, I don't see that either. You know, and you know, especially with your whole life equalizer thing. Yeah, I can see. You know, you tell me. So no, I'm gonna see Wolverine like. All right, so that was your list. That was quick and painless. So we can actually move on. So now we got Omega Chaos list. So it's interesting to see what Omega Chaos thinks. All right, so starting off, he has they have forbidden nothing. All right, limited Shadow Fusion states that probably the best hit. I don't think TCG Konami will copy OCG hitting the fusion effect that it can use monsters from the deck as fusion materials. Its opponent summons for the extra deck is just way too insane. You know, Shadow Fusion is way more, far more balanced. I definitely agree. I'm just trying to base where Konami wants to do with Shadows. Now, if they want to put it to one, then hey, more power to them. But you know, two, I can see two. I can see two testing water. Two, if it's still too powerful, then go ahead and ban it. Especially since the deck's kind of falling off and not being the, you know, tippity top best deck of the format anymore. I can definitely see them kind of just being like, all right, put Shadow Fusion out of the another two and see how it goes from there. And hitting the deck's consistency by putting Mathematician to two and Sinister Shadow Games to one. Maybe Construct to one. I think that would just be fun. I think that'd be fun. Alright, next. True God from the Unaware from Burning Abyss, of course. Just way too abusable in that deck. I don't think Konami wants to hit any of the core Burning Abyss monsters. I definitely agree. To an extent. I think that maybe True God to one would probably kill the deck. Because, you know, there would just be no... you would weaken Skarm, you'd weaken the whole deck in general. Maybe the two, we'll go ahead and try two. But I think one's a little bit too extreme right now. So hit it to two, test the waters. The deck's not, it's still not, they don't want deck. You know, it's not like they're never getting support. They're still getting that, what, spell card in the next set. So they're still getting support for the deck. But it's still, you know, top deck. But, you know, if we can just not get a couple pegs by maybe putting maybe a short guy down to two, maybe Mathematician down to two, maybe hit maybe like Fire Lake down to one, so you don't have the consistency of that loop, because that's just blatantly a loop. Like, yeah, that blatantly should be addressed. Fire Lake, yeah, I'm not saying you should ban Fire Lake, but you know, just put it down to one. Fire Lake is a little bit too powerful to be ran at three, and you know, it's a loop that will hit out of your opponent and pop three cards per turn. You know, like, you know, Gladiator Beast eat your heart out, because the deck does it way better. All right, next, Skill Drain. Indirect hit for Cleopwood so that they can't just shut down all the monster effects while benefiting from it. I definitely agree. I think Skill Drain should be at one. Demok, time for it to come back. Ban Soul Charge and we'll talk. Like, I'm not a big fan of Soul Charge. Next, then he's up this. I like it to be banned, but Konami probably limit it first and maybe then ban it sometime later. I can see that. I can actually see just Danny just going down to one and Konami just being like, oh, well, everybody gets one, you know? If you know the consistency of Danny's, it's not as broken. Now, it won't be like, hey, this guy won this tournament because he's running triple Danny's and your opponent can't play Yu-Gi-Oh! It'd be just like, oh, Konami got lucky with the one Vanity. So, you know, I generally wouldn't like it just because I'd play on number generators and I would just probably see Vanity's all the goddamn time. But, you know, I can see that. All right. Semi-limited. Monster Gate. Boost to Infernoids. No, I don't see any of that moving. Yeah, I'm like I said, I'm a very conservative person when it comes to ban lists, and I generally won't do things or move things unless I see Konami doing it first. You know, like if Konami, like I don't know. I feel like I'm kind of like Konami's bitch on this one, but I'm just like. If Konami doesn't want to move it, then I don't think it should be moved. And then Konami moves like, oh, okay, Konami, you want to move it? Fine. Then it can be moved, you know? So, you know, Monster Gate has been at one for forever, you know, forever. So I just don't really see a reason to move it, you know? Same thing with you saying that reasoning should be at three, unlimited. You know, I don't know. I don't see that either, you know? No booster Infernoids. I mean, you know, if they need to, they're probably just gonna, you know, not do anything when it comes to Infernoids, test their water, and then if they need a boost or they're just not being, you know, up to par, then they can address it in the next list. But for right now, I doubt it. Gores to three, that's fine. Gale to three, okay, whatever. And my rap prediction list, my Do It Bandless prediction video on my channel as well. Doing my idea of bandless video this time, last time I got it. Hey, people disagree with you, and everybody said to your opinion, but, you know, it's not about the dislikes. You got 8 dislikes, but it's not about the dislikes, it's about the views. So, yeah, I'd say go ahead and do it. I will go ahead and watch it and see and get your opinion, but so far this list isn't too terrible. I can definitely see the hate. I can see the hate in your eyes. Mega Chaos. You hate the meta. You hate the meta. You didn't go so far as, you know, punch a Cleeplate in the face so hard that it's just broken, but, you know, a nice kick in the nuts to Burning Abyss and a nice kick in the butt in the nuts to Shadal. So yeah, I don't know. Alright. So there was the Mega Chaos. Next is Red Ace 1997. A little bit older than you, if you were born in 1997. Alright, so, I've got a couple cards to talk about here, so, yeah. And, I might set aside, every Monday to do any other comments, if I have any other comments. But, I'll figure it out. I'll figure it out. Because this is, what is this, part 3? So, yeah. Yeah, it's part 3, so, I'll figure that out. Alright, so, starting off, Redis says, sacrifice to one, killing tool, hitting tool would destroy Cleopatra, anything else would be a dick move. Someone else is seeing some play, and then a pendulum. I don't think anything in the deck's gonna get hit. That's literally like their money card. That's literally their thing, so, that's their money deck. So, if there was gonna be anything to hit the deck, it would be indirectly, and I'd say, Skill Drain. You know, some decks I see don't even run Skill Drain, some Clipper decks, so, you know, just being able to just put that down to one along with Vanities and maybe, promote a different kind of play would just be fun, but, Sacrifice is definitely a hit that I see in the future, you know, maybe when we start starting to step away from Cleeplet and move on, I can definitely see that card going down to one, definitely. Next, D-Fissure slash Macro to 3, a necessary evil that would give better options against Shadal's Burning Abyss and future graveyard line decks. No. Konami's not gonna do that. They did those cards for a reason. They did that for a reason. Generally, decks that float and have graveyard lines last a lot longer than decks that don't. You know, because they can continue building up resources that can continue in the duel, and that would make some meta. That would make some relevant, and that's what keeps them in the game longer to make Konami receive more money. Alright? Look at Teller Knights, you know. They generally don't, you know, the only thing that's keeping them in the game is their Triple Rota and their Deneb to Altair plays. If Deneb couldn't do Altair and vice versa, that deck would already be dead. So, there's some really the ability to keep and stay in the game. It's a very powerful thing. And, with D-Fission and Macro at 3, it would just be too crazy. Like, if you need to, we have Banisher of the Radiance and Banisher of the Light. You know, they do the same thing, but, it's generally unhealthy for these cards. These cards are unhealthy. I'm not saying that, you know, we should bring unhealthy cards off the ban list to combat unhealthy decks. I don't think that's right, you know. I think we should just hit the unhealthy deck, bring them down to, you know, a relevant level or a level that's not as powerful as where they were before, and it'd be fine. Alright, next, Sengen unbanned. If Skarm is at 3, then this card should be unbanned. I really wouldn't care, you know. If Sengen gets unbanned, sure. Do I think it's gonna get unbanned? I doubt it. No, it just didn't seem like they would do something like that, but I can definitely see Skangan being unbanned. Next, Dark Tide Fighter unbanned. The ride has been released, therefore, to say to assume it's coming off, unless Konami forgot about the card. Yeah, I can see that card coming to 3. That's fine. Alright, next. Nurse of the Fallen 1, Bad Reaction to 1, banned something I keep preaching. Both creating the Adrenaline Burn decks and the former card being a video game exclusive just needs to stop. I mean, I totally agree. I don't like those cards either. Do I think they're gonna get hit? No, because they're not even relevant. You know, it's been a cool minute since the burn deck has even topped or been relevant, so they're just gonna, once again, they're just gonna skid by, you know. Unless all of a sudden the burn deck is the top deck of the format and all everybody's running burn, and, you know, burn is just, you know, wrecking the format. Doubt anything. I doubt Konami's gonna do anything about that. Alright. Next, Sacred Sword 7 stars 2, since the Dragon Warriors have remained dormant and all the dragons are banned slash limited, this card can be moved up relevant with no harm in it. A double summon is not the relevant power card it once was. I really wouldn't care if it moved, but I just don't see Konami moving it just because it's a Dragon Ruler card. You know, with Konami's hip to Dragon Rulers, you know, arguably one of the most powerful decks in all of Yu-Gi-Oh! They hit this, and the deck hasn't been relevant since, so I don't think Konami wants to try to test the waters and move anything Dragon Ring related or spark anything Dragon Ring related, because that's not what they want to promote. So by not moving anything, it's kind of like keeping it dormant, you know. It's kind of like, you know, laying, it's like kind of like, you know, a bear sleeping in a cage, and you're not going to go near that cave, you know. You could probably, like, tip-throw your way through that cave, but instead of going through the cave, you gotta go around the cave to not wake up the bear, you know. So they're really not the ones to shake the boat, Konami. You know, if they do put up the two, then alright, fair, but I don't know. Alright, next. Dizzy Dota 2 and Mermels have moved to a less OTK-centric build from the limiting of dragoons and guns. This may be able to move back to two, although I think it's one you'll disagree on the most and might get pissed at me on. I'm not gonna get pissed on you on it, I just don't see it, you know. There's a reason why Konami hit the deck, and, you know, despite their hits to Mermels, the deck is still good. It's still a really good deck, you know. I didn't take Mermels off of Daily Duels because it's not a good deck. It's still a really good deck. I took it off because it was, I wanted to try other things, but literally Mermels have been the deck on Daily Duels for the longest time, like the longest running deck on Daily Duel, from the beginning almost to like episode like 450 or so. So, Mermels are still really good, you know. Mermels can still top to this day, so there's no reason to move or promote anything Mermel related, especially since D.Va can go into an easy Armades, which is definitely a card that can kick the ass of a lot of decks that are relevant, you know. Just being able to go Armades, run over your Burning Abyss, or your Armades, run over your Shadal. So you know, I just don't see it. Alright, and any other suggestions that were previously discussed from other comments? Alright, thank you. And then also, why are people saying that Fender Duster should get unbanned because Regeki is two different animals? I agree. And that's kind of getting ridiculous that people keep on saying that, you know, Hybrid Fender Duster should be unbanned because Regeki is again banned. They're totally, totally different monsters. Two totally, totally, totally different monsters. So, I definitely say no to that. So, no. Not a big fan of that happening. Definitely not. Alright, so I think that's it for now. Like I said, I'm probably going to get some more comments, and if I don't, then I'll figure out what to do about Monday. I'm not sure what I'll do about Monday. Yeah, because I just kind of feel like it would be unfair to have, you know, Lunar and Hyago and not have anybody else. If I don't get any more comments or anything to discuss along those lines on during this up, because I've literally sat here and I just went and blazed through all these comments and just cut it up in different videos. So this is all in one sitting, all three of these parts, but you're gonna get in different parts, of course. But if you guys have any more comments or any more questions, be sure to go ahead and comment down. I will go ahead and do like a mock wrap up and wrap it all up and so a nice little bow at the end. If there's anything I missed or anything that you guys missed that you guys wanted to hear after hearing these three parts, and be sure, then of course I can do that tomorrow being Monday, and my ban list prediction will be going up on the 1st, so I look forward to it. Alright, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this. Thank you guys for taking the time to go ahead and do this. Like I said, this is the final part, and thank you. These are a blast to do. I have fun, doing these videos. I hope you guys enjoyed commenting and listening to what I have to say. So I said this would have been like an hour long video, so I'm glad I decided to split it up into different parts. And like I said, if we have some more comments, then I will get to those tomorrow. So thank you for taking the time to go ahead and watch the duels if you are watching duels and listen. So thanks for watching, thanks for all the support, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Like I say, it might just be me by myself. Instead, I'm either A, this is what I'm going to do, I'm either A, going to wrap up any other comments that you guys have to say about the ban list before I put my ban list prediction, or B, I might actually talk about my YCS Anaheim, experience day. That way, on Tuesday, we can get right back into me commentating about my day, so I can commentate about my Monday and continue on with that and get that out of the way, because I still need to get that out of the way. So, it'll be either or. Alright, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. So thanks for watching, thanks for all the support, and I will see you guys and my ban list prediction. Alright, thanks for watching.